and welcome back to my channel. My name's Rachel and I make videos on fashion, travel, and environmentalism. So if you like any of those things, you should consider subscribing to my channel. This video is kind of like a part two of my video, how to save money so you can travel more. So I will link that here. But in this video, I will talk about how I save money while I'm traveling so I can prolong my travels and make my money just go further. So my first piece of advice would be to walk or to take public transit. When you do either of those things, you are going to be seeing way more of the country that you're in and kind of experience it through a local's eye. When you're walking, you can just take in the scenery more, kind of learn your surroundings, and you might even remember where you're going by the second or third day. And if you take public transit as well, that's also a cheaper way to get you longer distances. Public transit and walking is way cheaper than taking a taxi or an Uber. So it's definitely something that you should consider wherever you're traveling. I often take this into regard when I think about getting to and from the airport, and even just every day, of course, but to and from the airport, there's often buses that can take you from the airport into the city center or many places that you need to go. So really look into that. It'll end up being way cheaper for you. My second piece of advice would be to stay in a hostel. So I recently started staying in hostels and I absolutely love them. They are such a cheap way to travel and a great way to make friends. This is especially great if you are solo traveling, or honestly, it's just great all the time. You can meet so many like-minded people who are also traveling with you, and you know, maybe even find someone to hang out with that day. One of my favorite things about traveling is meeting and making friends on the other side of the world, so definitely something I would recommend. In a lot of European countries, it's like $15 a night, and that compared to staying in a hotel, it's just a no-brainer for me. And a lot of hostels you stay in will either have a kitchen that you can cook your own food in, or they'll have free breakfasts. I once stayed at a hostel that had a free dinner. Those little perks are so amazing and all for way cheaper than a hotel. I know that a lot of people I talk to are scared of hostels because they don't really know what to expect and they worry about their own safety. I'm actually thinking about making a video all about hostels and my best tips for staying in a hostel. So let me know if you'd be interested in that in the comments. Another tip would be to grocery shop. So this is something I've been recently getting into, I think ever since I went to Iceland, because Iceland was just so expensive. So I was really thinking about ways to minimize my expenses on that trip. A lot of the time what I like to do is buy either something simple I can make for breakfast, maybe like avocado toast, and then I'd like to buy something that I can make quickly, maybe some materials I can make a sandwich with, or something I could take to go. This way I have a breakfast to start my day off quickly so I can get out the door and start exploring whatever city I'm in. But also I have a sort of snack slash lunch for later if needed. My next tip would be to travel with friends if you can. When you travel with friends, you can split the cost of so many things. Think accommodations and food and transportation. Last summer, I'll link it here, but I did a whole Europe trip, and at the end of my trip, I met up with 5 of my friends, so there were 6 of us in total. It was pretty hectic, but we saved so much on transportation because we could get private cars because we're splitting it 6 ways. Airbnbs, we stayed in houses, we stayed in humongous, amazing Airbnbs, split 6 ways was so cheap. In a lot of countries, it was actually cheaper than staying in a hostel to have our own private place with like a full kitchen and a patio and everything. So think about that. If you can get some friends to travel with you, it is a really smart idea. I also always say that if I was to go to a country where I wanted to rent a car, I'd want to go with a couple friends because then we could split the cost of gas and the cost of the car rental. My next piece of advice would be to get acquainted with locals, whether that be someone who works at a coffee shop or someone who runs a souvenir stand. If you can, you know, get friendly with some locals, you could chat them up. You could be like, hey, what's the cheapest way that I can get to point A to point B? Maybe they know a specific bus route that you don't. You could ask them, hey, where is a cheap place to get some really good dinner? Those sorts of things obviously come naturally to locals who have lived there for years and years, but something that you would not be as well versed with. So remember to always be friendly to everyone you interact with, because, well, not only to be a good person and to be friendly, but also because if you can get yourself acquainted with some locals, they may be able to share some tips and strategies and advice that will help you save money. My next piece of advice would be to travel during off seasons. So if you are able to, for me it's a little hard because I am still a student, but if I wasn't a student, I would probably be traveling like mid-September when everyone's back at school. I love going to Europe in the winter. I love going to Europe in the fall. It's absolutely amazing. probably Europe in the fall is probably like my favorite time to go to Europe, but you have to think about when flights are going to be the most expensive and when they're going to be the cheapest. A way you can do this is to look on Google Flights. You could also just Google when the off season is of a certain place you're going to. The only place I wouldn't recommend doing this, because I would like to plan a trip there eventually as well, would be to like Asian countries. Because I feel like if you go in certain off seasons, it could also be raining season, which means, you know, the whole time you're there, it could be raining. This really depends on where you're going, but I would say if you travel during an off season, it's going to be way less expensive. My next piece of advice, along with flights, would be to monitor your flights. So you can do this by yourself, you can set this up on Google, or you can do it through apps like Hopper. I use Hopper sometimes, but often I will just try to monitor it myself or set up a certain reminder on Google. What I like to do is first set my browser to private, because if you don't set your browser to private, it actually can up the prices of flights because Google will know what flights you're searching for. So set your browser to private and that will help you start sort of stay incognito. You can look at like the prices for the whole month. If you go on Google Flights, it actually compares all the different flight companies in one place. So that's what I like to use. Along with that, book ahead would be my next piece of advice. I think that a lot of places, when you book ahead, not only for flights, but for excursions, for transportation, they often end up being cheaper. I know a lot of like travel agencies and companies, if you book ahead, there's sort of like an early bird discount. So if you know when you're going to have time off and you know when you're going to be able to travel, try to pre-plan your trips so that you can get all your flights organized and some excursions. I know a lot of places when you pay for excursions at the last minute, the prices are inflated because you're kind of desperate and you're paying at the last minute. If you pre-plan a ballpark of what you want to do, it could end up saving you some money. My next piece of advice would be to travel with a carry-on, because when you travel with a carry-on, you don't have to pay that extra money for baggage. Baggage can get expensive, it adds up, and it's paid for each flight. If you have a connecting flight, that's gonna be even more. And it's also just hard to move around with that much baggage. I've been on long trips before where I really regretted bringing a bigger bag because it was so difficult when I was moving from place to place. My last couple trips, I've actually been traveling just with a carry-on. So this even includes my trip to Germany where it was in the fall and I had to wear different coats. It is possible to do. There's so many videos on YouTube that you can find of people who are light packers or fitting in their travels for like 2 weeks or 3 weeks or even a month in a carry-on. You just need to be strategic with what you're packing, maybe invest in some packing cubes, and it can kind of help like shrink your clothes a little. I also find, because I use a bunch of environmental bathroom products, that really limits what is being brought with me when I travel. If you are interested in that, I will link my 8 easy zero waste bathroom switches, because a lot of those are really good for traveling as well. My very last piece of advice would be to make friends. And don't just make friends to save money, make friends because it's fun. If you make friends with people from other parts of the world, maybe if you're traveling to their country one day, they could host you and you could stay in their place for free. Maybe if they're traveling to your country one day, you could host them and you can show them around for free. I think traveling really brings out the humanity and the good in people. And when you make friends, it could lead you down the road to getting a really unique cultural experience in another country. But that could also just be the Canadian me wanting everyone to be nice all the time, ever. All right, that is everything for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and you consider subscribing to my channel. Like I mentioned before, I make videos on fashion, travel, and environmentalism, and I post every week at 11 a.m. on Sundays. Also, you can follow me on Instagram and TikTok. I post a lot on there as well. That's everything for this video. I will see you next time. Bye. I got so much back, I think I'm never running out, yeah. Bust me down a whip, bitch, I don't do this for no clout, hey. I got so much back, I think I'm never running out.